everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is Madden 17 on EA Sports. Opening week in the NFL is an exciting time for everybody, including these two teams here today. It's the Bills going up against the Ravens. With that, time to get up to Baltimore, Maryland, as I'm pleased to introduce our new broadcast team for 2016, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Larry, for Madden, it's a new broadcast team. For the Ravens, it's natural grass on the field. That's what's different here as we welcome you inside M&T Bank Stadium in Baltimore. Today, the opener of the 2016 NFL season between the Buffalo Bills and the Baltimore Ravens. And partner, the Bills coming off a 500 season at 8-8. The Ravens, a season they'd like to forget, 5-11 last year.
That's not Ravens football, and they want to get back to playing at the level that they're used to, which is playoff caliber. What their head coach John Harbaugh said last year was like a cannonball to the gut. Then you flip it over to Buffalo.
For it with Peterson. It's a gain of a couple, and it'll be second and goal.
J.J. Watt makes another tackle there, and it's for a minimal gain. And let's face it, if that's all you're going to get running the ball, you're not going to have much success against him and his team.
Or, yeah, you better find a way to go around J.J. Watt, which isn't easy to do.
It's really not, because you got to try everything. Can you go around him? Can you go by him? Can you influence him to get him out of position so maybe you can wall him off? He's a really sharp, intelligent player, as well as a physical specimen.
So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down. We've become so accustomed to it, you sort of take it for granted.
You really do, but he is so good that every team in his division, every year, is trying to make sure they draft people charged with trying to block J.J. Watt. So far, hasn't been too successful.
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Tavon Austin from 3 yards out. And the Bills take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. So on third and medium, they dial up the pass, and it works to hit the end zone.
And it's really not...
First down, and he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
The second-year man from Nebraska, it's Amir Abdullah. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. 7 yards on the pickup there, and now they've got it first and goal.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
And a really long drive here, and it goes on and on. The toss play, Stewart. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the four. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there.
Let's go. Let's
Time running out here on the play clock. Again, it's Stewart on second and goal. And he is going to lose yardage here. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and that's going to bring up an interesting third and goal.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
Now from back at the five, this is third and goal. An extra defensive back on the field here for third and goal. On third and goal, Palmer. And this is caught on the sideline. But no, they'll say out of bounds. He caught it but was not in bounds. Incomplete. A third down, he tried to stay in bounds, did all he could. He caught it but was led a little bit too far.
Yeah, and that's always difficult, isn't it? Because you know half of your body is trying to stay behind while the other half is reaching out trying to catch the football. The top half worked. It was the bottom half that was in question.
And Crosby puts it through. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So give them three there. A good drive gets them inside the five, but they couldn't punch it in.
And credit this defense, too. That was the old bend, but don't break.
Receiver right. Throwing now is Brady. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude, but I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
Now he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. And he is into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Their dangerous wide receiver from 17 yards out. And the Bills will add on to their lead. And on that one, able to catch it, also able to have the wherewithal to take it in for the score.
And how about the phases of a successful catch and a completion of a play? Look the ball.
Second down, here's Palmer. And to the right side here, it's Allen. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. Dwayne Allen, an 18-yard touchdown grab. And the Ravens have cut it to within a score. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails. Not at all. This guy can make...
52 left to play in this second quarter. We're back to Baltimore after this. A reminder coming up at this and every halftime this season, we'll be checking in with Larry Ridley in Orlando for highlights and analysis of our first half.
LR, that's my man.
That's your guy. Now the Ravens bring out an extra defensive back here on third down.
Could be a blitzer.
Brady going to try and throw on third down. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he picks up the first as he's able to take it down to the 7-yard line.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Here's Brady. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
You ever notice that when Tom Brady does get hit and dropped to the ground, there's some guys back to him pretty quickly to check on his health, aren't there?
That's exactly right. For as much as he throws, doesn't take a lot of square shots, but took one there.
He's really smart in the pocket, isn't he? Even out of the pocket. He understands where the pressure is coming from. He senses people. You're exactly right. Doesn't take too many direct ones, but that...
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Their big-bodied receiver, already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Bills will extend their lead. So they've had two drives, and he's had the two receiving touchdowns.
And how about a game plan where you decide to force feed or feature?
Second down, Palmer, penalty mark, and no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. That's one of those ones that is so hard to judge, but defensive holding there, that's what the referee saw. Now this will be the ninth play on this drive.
So
the play clock's running down. Following the penalty, here's Stewart. And a short pickup there, down to about the 9. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
That was a really nice play, being able to stack that one up. When they get back in the huddle, he's got to tell his guys up front, great job. They kept people off of him, allowed him to run free, and make the hit on the runner.
He filled the gap nicely, kept him to just a 1-yard gain. Another run for Stewart. He's been busy. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
When you're putting together a formula for winning defense, it's exactly what we're seeing in this game. Controlling the line of scrimmage, attacking, and changing everything so that now they're playing in the offense's backfield. They're playing an excellent game.
6 yards on the pickup, and it'll be fourth down.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
They'll need to get the playoff quickly. And Crosby puts it through, and that'll make this an 8-point game. A decent drive there to start the third quarter. They only salvaged 3 out of it, but they do inch a bit closer.
Yeah, still lots of time to go in this one. Take the points, move on, and let your defense try to get the ball back.
outside. They're playing press coverage. Back to the ground now with Stewart. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
Not an ideal spot to be on first down, but I love that the play caller did not immediately abandon the running game and say, okay, we've got to throw it in order to pick it up. Stayed with the run, was rewarded with a big-time pickup. Now they're in second and manageable.
Play clock winding down. On second down, they run with Stewart. And he will take it in for a Ravens touchdown. Jonathan Stewart taking it in from a yard out. And now the Ravens, they're just a two-point conversion away from tying this up. And he was excellent on that drive. He deserved to be the one to get across the chalk.
Oh, I agree with you totally. A workhorse on the drive. And how about that last decisive run to punch it in?
Now a big play here as the Ravens are going to go for the two-point conversion. Throw, and this one incomplete. So they went for the two, they don't get it. Play clock. They run here with Stewart. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play there. Second down.
But it was stopped on that play. We said plenty of carries all afternoon. Every now and then the defense is going to win one, but I don't think they'll shy away from handing it to him the rest of the game.
And that'll be incomplete. He was looking for Terrence Williams that time. And that's going to make it third down and 10. And here comes play number 6 on this drive.
Extra DB on the field for the Bills here on third down.
Yeah, maybe thinking pass. On third down, Palmer. Can't find anyone open. This will be caught just inside the 10. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and that'll bring up fourth down.
Partner, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right there, kind of played into their hands. And Crosby puts it through, and with that, they have taken the lead by a point here in the fourth. So the drive here ends with a field goal, and that does give them the lead, but this one is still a long ways from over.
And you love to be able to look up at the scoreboard and see that you're out in front, but then you take...
week one behind us now. Always tough to start the season on the losing side.
It is, but you know, the teams that know how to recover, that understand it's just week one, are the teams that will sustain and end up having a good season.
So for the Bills, it wasn't always pretty, but they do eke out the week one victory here by a field goal. And they will head home next week to take on the New York Jets. Meanwhile, for the Ravens, they obviously fall to 0-1 with the defeat. And they'll try to get back on the beam next week as they'll head to Cleveland to take on the Browns. So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. From Baltimore, so long, everybody.